KILR Killer Games.
We are back. KILR Gamer
and NerdGamer2K.
NerdGamer2K, and we are continuing our hardcore survival mode in Minecraft. And this is what you're seeing is the general area that we are currently in right now. So let's talk about what's been going on. We are getting ready to do some mining. So let's talk about some mining techniques, because there's a bunch of them and everyone has their thing and what they like and the reasons why they like it, etc., etc. I'm not going to go over all of them, but I'll go over just a few. So there's what's called branch mining, which you pretty much start at a point and you just dig in a straight line. As you can see, pretty much either one. If we go with the one on the left, if you're at that dot in the red square in the middle, you're digging forward. I'm not going to sit there and try to count all those spaces. And then you dig the other way. So you got this really long hallway. And then you branch like every 2 to 3. Like every 3 blocks. Some prefer 4, but you're basically making these long branches, as you can see there. And then the one on the right, it's similar, where you're making these smaller branches, but I guess you're covering a little bit more. But anyway, me personally, I think especially the one on the right is really confusing. I think it's easy to get lost in. You got what's called quad mining. Quad meaning it's trying to get as much as it can. If you take like a square area like this and you're trying to get all 4 quadrants or whatever, that's what this is. And they're good. I haven't really tried it, but what we're going to be doing is something, I guess, that takes the best from all of that. And that's called Phoenix X Mining. This is developed by NZPhoenix. At least that's where I found the information. The idea behind this is that it makes the return trip to where you start it easier. So that way you're not getting lost. You're not trying to figure out which hallway to go down. I remember when I first did mining and I was doing all kinds of branches, I was all over the place. I couldn't even find my way back.
Wow.
So this makes it a lot easier. It's easy to expand. Some will say it's not very efficient. I guess because they're looking to get ore quickly or something. Or, with as little breaking of blocks as possible. But I'll be honest with you. Whenever I do this Phoenix mining, I never have a problem trying to get ore. I get gold, I get diamond, I get all kinds of stuff. So so what if it takes me an extra 5 minutes than, an efficient form of mining? Hey, at least I get the stuff, right?
True.
It's not like I'm going to be sitting there playing the game and do nothing but mining. I guess you could if you want to, but, I kind of like to do some other things too. But anyway, let's talk about how this works. So what you're going to do, and this is what we did in the last episode, we started with a 4x4 room, and you can start like 2 to 3 blocks high. So as you know, I like playing at level 11. So if you did 2-3 blocks, you could be clearing out level 11, 12, and 13. And the trick behind this is to remember 3s and 6s. Remember your it's like divisions of 3s. Think triangle. And the way you start is in that 4x4 room, you're going to go to the... You could do this from either corner, but the reason why it's done this way is to help you remember. It's kind of like a pattern type of thing. It's easy to remember. So start in the, when you're looking at a wall of the room, start on the left corner. It's like this one here. So you will dig three blocks, as you can see there. This is your main box, all right? So what we're going to do, you're going to be making this hallway. I recommend doing this hallway first, okay? It's going to be three. What I do is I dig three blocks at a time, and I put a torch on every third block, because on every third block, those branches are going to be coming off. So after we dig three, we are going to make a right. And then we're going to dig six, just like you see right there. So it's like you dig three, turn right, dig another three, dig another three. And then you're going to make a left, dig another three, and dig three more. That's where that red thing is at. But when you dig three, you're not going to be doing a too high dig. You're only going to do one. So you're going to do the one, like the second block, as if you're making a window. So you're going to dig three blocks as a window, and you're going to put a torch on that middle block. And the reason for that torch is when you come back around, you're going to see that torch, and it's going to be a visual reference saying, oh, okay, I need to go so many more blocks more. And this is what we'll show you. Okay, so after you put your torch there, now you're going to turn and dig six until you get back to that main hallway. That's why it's important that you make that hallway first, otherwise you don't know where it is. So once you get back to the main hallway, you're going to see that torch that you lay down. So once you get back there, now you're pretty much just, you're continuing. You're going to be doing the opposite of what you just did. You're going to continue and you're going to dig six. And then you're going to turn right this time. And you're going to, why is that there? I think my visual aids are in some type of order. But anyway, as you can see on the left side there, how after you make a right, you're going to dig three, and then you're going to dig another three, and you're going to place another torch in that red area. Then you're going to turn right, dig six, and you're going to be back to the main hallway. And then you're going to dig six again, and you're going to see where I've got circled that first torch that you put down. So when you see that first torch, that's your signal to like, oh, okay, I need to dig six more blocks. So when you dig six more blocks and then make a left, dig three, and then your three block window, you put another torch on that middle one. And so now you go back, whoops. After you put that torch, you're going to dig your way back to your main hallway. So you can count the blocks back if you want, or you just dig, 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 dig until you get back to the main hallway where your torch is at. And then you do it again. You keep digging all the way down. You'll see your torch over on the other side. You do six more blocks, and then you make your right turn, dig three, and then your three block window. And you just keep going. You're doing this zigzagging movement, and you don't have to sit there and you really don't have to sit there and try to count a whole lot of blocks. Just remember that you're doing threes or sixes. And when you see that torch, it's a visual reference for you. And you can make this as this zigzag as big as you want. That's why it's easily expandable. And it will always take you back to that main hallway. That'll take you straight right back to that first room that you built, that 4x4 room. And that's what we got highlighted here. So you can do that zigzag on all four sides of that cube. And each of them has a main hallway that takes you right back to where you started. And in my opinion, this works. This works great. Works great for me. You're covering a lot of blocks. There may be like a few blind spots where there's some blocks that you don't actually see, but the chance of something actually being there is relatively rare. But yeah, so this is Phoenix Mining. It's an easy, quick way to get back to your starting room. I like it because you're not going to get lost, because you've got your torches on the floor of the main hallway, and those zigzags really don't connect to anything else. Just pretty much just follow your branch or your zigzag, whatever it is, to your main hallway, and then just head on back. Easy to count and keep track of because of the threes and the sixes. And it's easy to expand. Like I said, I mean, you can make that zigzag as big as you want. But more importantly, you get more ores. Yes, and more ores are always good.
More.
Yes, that is misspelled for a reason. If you don't understand, if you don't understand the more ores, I don't know. I can't really help you there. Anyway, that is what we're going to be doing. So let's get right to it. You can't explain that at all. You can try, but you can't explain that. Because it rhymes with Minecraft.
Whoa, I just realized that.
Ah, see?
Hey, I didn't explain that. You can't explain that.
I didn't expect that either. So take that. And that, folks, is the end of our game. No, I'm just kidding.
The end.
The end. Aww.
Best game ever.
Best game ever. All right. Let's go ahead and continue with our hardcore game, which is right here.
The only one in hardcore.
See? We're not cheating. I'm telling you. Hardcore mode. All right.
And I love this song. The cheats are
turned off. All right. Play world. Okay, so this is where we left off.
I'm there so is... lost already.
Okay, let's back up a little bit here.
Oh, I see it now.
So when we were here, remember, we were doing that Phoenix mining thing, and we started in that 4x4 room. Okay, we put our crafting table and furnace over here. Do I have? Yes, I do. I got some. So let's put some of our coal in here. How many Oh, we only got three torches. Okay, perfect. Since we're here, let's go ahead and make some more torches with our charcoal. Remember I was saying we're going to get rid of... Use the charcoal for your torches. Because usually, I mean, torches, unless I really need them, I tend to leave them where they're at. Because you can make tons of them. Alright, we're going to go ahead and get ourselves some coal here. I remember what I was saying, you can never have enough coal. I mean, one, you get easy experience for this stuff. Plus, I've noticed that... I don't need a hoe there. I've noticed that when I tend to travel around, I'll make other furnaces where I go when I'm going between two different areas. So it's kind of nice to
have
a supply
benches of,
you know, coal, so you're not having to carry it with you and everything. All right, since we do have some coal in here, let's just throw this in here and we can start smelting the gold that we got. Because that'll be cool. As a matter of fact, didn't I get... I did get some redstone. Awesome. I need a chest in here somewhere. I thought I'd put one in here. I guess not. Let's see. Alright, remember, make a chest, do a square. Gotta have a hole in the middle. Like a donut.
Like a wooden donut.
This is a wooden donut. Let's see. We'll put that right. Oh.
That's so awkward.
It is awkward. Hold on here. I wanted to show something. Actually, I think I have a solution. All right. I want to show you guys something. All right. So you may be thinking, well, why don't we just put that there? And
just move the apple.
Yeah, I wasn't thinking about it. Do you notice how it's not working? It takes two blocks in order to open and stuff like that. Although I'm curious. Let me see something. See, now that works, but I wonder if we put that back there. Nope. Okay. That was worth a try.
How would that change that?
I don't know. I've seen some interesting things done with videos. Okay, we're just going to go ahead and put some of our stuff in here. And including the apple, we'll put that in there too. Let's take the meat. We'll keep a ladder. Sometimes I tend to forget what I have. Ooh. We need... Okay, I got some of that. Okay. Don't mind me, folks. I just realized that I need to make myself some more stone pickaxes. Getting an upgrade. I already got an iron pickaxe. I don't consider a stone pickaxe an upgrade to it. Anyone know why there's such a delay in these achievements? Seems to be like that every time I play. I wonder if it's a bug that maybe they are fixing for later.
Maybe, I don't know.
Ah, wait a minute, it's done. Okay, good. Since we have this gold, I'm going to build something here, or make something. Something that I find really useful. And it is a clock. So what you're going to do is you're going to put your redstone right here in the middle, and you are going to make this kind of diamond shape around it. You're going to get this clock. Now you may be thinking, well, what's this clock useful for? Well, check it out. When you have the, and you can see it right here, or when you wherever you happen to have it, you could have it in here, as a matter of fact. This tells you what time of day it is.
So, I never knew how to read it.
Yeah, so that this is how it works. This black part here is the night. This thing that you're seeing right here is the sun. And when it gets straight up and down, it's midday. And so this would continue to go this way in a clockwise direction, like a regular clock. So once the sun starts coming down here, you're going to see the black on this side. So you're going to see that when this black comes up here, you know, it's now nighttime, and then you'll see something representing a moon to let you know when it's midnight, I guess. Until it goes all the way around. So what I find useful about this is because we're all the way down here in the mine cave, you know, that we've created. It's kind of nice to know if we wanted to go up and do something on the surface and do it during the daytime, instead of having to climb all the way up and find out it's still dark outside, we got a clock right here. So this will tell us if it's daytime out there or not.
Because mining, you don't know unless you're paying attention to the music.
Yeah. It's funny. When I was first playing the game, one of the things that I had done, because I hadn't quite figured out, I hadn't figured out all the clock, or all the clocking. Oh my goodness. I hadn't figured out all the crafting recipes and stuff like that. And so my way of being able to tell if it was day or night or not, I had a glass up on the ceiling. But then that was back during a time where I was not digging as low as I'm digging now because, well, I didn't know where I was supposed to dig. I just started digging everywhere. And that's when I started doing branch mining and got lost and all this other stuff, which We might, you know, I was thinking about maybe trying some different mining techniques in some different areas that we go to. I don't know if I showed this or not. I don't think I did. If you want to repair something, you can put your damaged item here, your new item there. You can actually put it either way, I think. And you get a new whatever item that you're fixing. It does give it just a little boost of performance, not much.
Yeah, I don't think you ever showed that.
I never notice a boost in performance, I know that much. But according to the Minecraft wiki, there is. Alright. I'm going to go ahead and fill this up again. Maybe thinking, why are you filling that up? That's really dumb. When I first tried this Phoenix mining, I tend to, you know, when I dig stuff out, I wound up getting my counts messed up because I wound up digging on the wrong line and stuff like that. So I tend to fill things up so that way I don't lose track and count and stuff like that. All right, so let's do our threes. One, two, three. Okay, we are doing our main hallway, if you remember. So based on the design that I showed you, remember we're going in the left corner, and you can do that in this left corner, and that left corner, and that left corner. But the key is that you got to turn right and dig your first six. So if you do that, you're not going to cross over into what you're digging. Okay, that's important, because once you start crossing over into what you're digging,
then it gets confusing.
Not only that, but you've got multiple hallways all over the place. that's not good. Okay, so as a visual, we dig. Remember, you're digging out your hallway, so that way when you come back around, you're finding out where it was that your hallway's at. So remember, we're going six, and then we make a left, dig three. This is the window that I was telling you about, just one block. Put your torch in the middle, because when you come back and dig, you're going to be digging on that third block over there. You'll be digging right through, and you're going to see the torch right there. So dig back this direction. Boom, you've hit your main hallway. You do your six on this side. And then right here, we didn't put a torch here because we got lava, although...
We got nature's torch.
We got nature's torch. I am going to put that there for a reference, though. And then we dig back to the hallway. So now, let's go ahead and show you what it looks like when you're on now the second leg. Get our shovel here. Now, I've read that whenever there's sand or gravel, there tends to be water or lava nearby. Sometimes above, sometimes below. Sometimes that's accurate and sometimes it's not. Although I do hear water. Not quite sure where it's at. All right. See that? This is the window that we made. So now that we've hit this window, this is like a visual cue. It's like, oh, okay. I got to do six more blocks. See, remember your threes and sixes. So we hit here, six more blocks. One, two, three. And I recommend when you hear the bubbling and the water sounds, back up a little bit before you start using your pickaxe, just in case there happens to be something behind there.
Yeah.
And considering we're on hardcore mode.
Definitely want to watch
it. Yeah, definitely want to watch it. All right. See, I did that in threes. Okay, so now what we're going to do, make a right. One, two, three. All the way down here. Yes, it's dark. One, two, three. Put lights. Boom. That takes care of our light in this area here. We shouldn't have to worry about any spawns. Now we dig our way back. And you can count your way back if you want, or you can just kind of dig.
I'm counting.
Now, I just did six. What I tend to do is I'll put, since everything's in three and sixes, I tend to put a torch on every...
Well, look up.
Yeah, I know. I saw that. So I tend to put it on every sixth block. Now, I don't put it on the floor, because that will confuse me with the main hallway. So put your torches on the floor. Put any extra dish torches on the wall. Keep things separate. Okay, let's see. Don't need my fences there. All right, so I think you can dig this with a regular stone pick. Oh, no, you can't. I remember doing that one time. Here, we'll show you. If you do this with a stone pickaxe, one, it takes a while. You notice how you didn't get anything? All right. Don't make the mistake of going after gold or diamond using a stone pickaxe. You're not going to get anything. Make sure you make your iron pickaxe.
Also, be careful when you're digging straight upward.
Right. If you noticed, I was off to the side here a little bit.
You're still kind of in.
Kind of, yeah. So see, we're teaching you things on what to do and things of what not to do. Hopefully one of our examples of what not to do won't be one of the things that
happens.
Owns us.
Yeah.
All right, we're back to the... dirt. Another tip that I recommend is you've got your pickaxe here. Put blocks or something right next to it. That way, if you hit a thing of water or lava, definitely lava, you can quickly...
Spooky.
Yeah, woo! You can quickly switch to the... selection right next to it, so you can throw down a block and keep that lava from getting you. Likewise, I always put my sword right next to whatever tool that I'm using, pretty much for the same reason. If some zombie or creeper or something shows up, I want to have my weapon close at hand. I also keep my iron pickaxe like right on the other side of it right there. So I can, you know, switch back and forth. But anyway, always bring a water bucket with you. Keep that somewhere close just in case. All right, let's go ahead and continue to dig our hallway out a little bit. Let's see, I like to go 10 deep, and I've got 1, 2, 3, 4 so far. 1, 2, Well... Okay, do you see how that thing of cobblestone just kind of fell into the lava there?
Such a shame.
Such a shame. All right. We're going to dig this out a little bit. Okay. So what we're going to do is we are going to use our water source. Now, you can pick your water back up. You do it by right-clicking or the use commands. What we're going to do, don't put it down here on the lava itself, because then you'll lose your water. Put it up here, and then pick it back up again.
And float away.
And it took my torch. There it goes. Okay, so now...
Gold!
Gold! Check that out. But now it's dark, so we need to think about...
No monsters coming in.
So what I'm doing is kind of doing a makeshift hallway sort of thing, just so I can keep my count. Go ahead and kind of clear this out a little bit. Oh my. Now, I'm not following the pattern. I'm just kind of clearing this stuff out at the moment. Let's put some torches on the wall here. Let's see. Let's put one there. So what I'm doing, I'm just... I'm messing up is what I'm doing. There we go. So you can see I have my visual reference. I don't need to fill it all up, although I've done that sometimes. Alrighty, we got our gold. Now, what we need to be careful with, just because we put water down here, this is obsidian, in case you're wondering. Obsidian, it's like indestructible, pretty much. I mean, if you build a house out of obsidian, no creeper in the world is going to be able to blow it up. It's going to look like the most ugliest house ever, but it's pretty sturdy stuff. And because of that, you're not going to be able to use a iron pickaxe or a gold pickaxe or whatever to be able to get this. You're going to need a diamond pickaxe. And you need a couple of these blocks of obsidian in order to make an enchantment table. Enchantment tables are good because you can enchant your weapons and your armor, makes it more stronger. And also, this allows you to build a portal, which will take you to the Nether. And the Nether is great for traveling long distances, plus there's stuff in the Nether to gather in order to do, like, potions and stuff. Which is another good thing to kind of get into. Of course, keep in mind, you don't have to do all that stuff, but...
And diamonds can be used to make jukeboxes.
That's right. They can. Jukeboxes don't do very much unless you can get a disc, and...
Which isn't really that hard.
It's not too hard, now. And we'll have some tutorials on how to do that, too. Alright, so what I am doing is I'm kind of digging around. For all we know, there could be lava right underneath these blocks. Because we don't know how deep this lava river, or whatever it is... How far, you know, how far does it go? How deep does it go? We don't know. So let's dig down here. Okay, so we see blocks underneath. We're okay. Although, there could be something over here on this side. So let's dig here. Nothing. Looking good so far. Let's dig behind. Nothing. Okay. We are in the clear. Let's go ahead and dig the gold out. Right. Now we're going to get back to our counting. All right, so we got here, we got one that we dug, two, three. Let's go ahead and put another torch down here. I believe that was number five, so here's torch number six, two, three. Torch number seven right there. More coal. Torch number eight. Torch nine. And we'll do one more. Our pickaxe is about to break.
Perfect.
Perfect. Okay. Now keep in mind, you can expand this as far as you want, but I typically only go to about 10. And keep in mind, you've got three other sides on that 4x4 room that you can go off in the other directions. And that, I don't know, I think that tends to be pretty good because there's all these other cave systems and stuff that you can go through. So... I don't know. You may not want to stay in the same place the whole time, but you can if you want to. I like to go explore. All right. We're going to continue. We're pretty much going to keep mining until we get to the end there. So let's see.
Ooh. Spooky.
spooky music. Let's see what kind of ore we can pick up. All right, so let's go ahead and use some water. Awesome, here's our torch. Let's go ahead, we'll put these blocks here just so we have a reference. Okay, so 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, we got some iron down there. Question is, do we have any lava underneath? Doesn't look like. Let's go over here. Don't get too close to the torch as you wind up axing it. Okay, we should be safe by mining there. Always be careful. Make sure that there's nothing. If you know you're near lava, just be careful when you do your mining. Now, the coal, the gold, the iron, they're all in a group, which is called a vein. Some veins are bigger than other veins. You notice with coal, there tends to be a lot.
Wait, a vein or a bane?
Vein. Like a vein in your
body.
Body, right. So, typically with iron, gold, diamond, there tends to be like maybe 4 blocks. Sometimes a little bit more, sometimes a little less. But looks like this one may have had 5. So just be sure to dig around and make sure that you're not missing everything. All right. Let's keep digging down here. Let's make sure that we don't have any more stuff waiting down here. All right. Well, I think we're going to be fine. Have famous last words.
I love you. I don't know. That way we don't die.
It's like, I just wanted to let you know that,
I love you, bro.
I love you, bro. I hear a skeleton. I think he loves us, too.
I think, too.
You hear 2 of them?
No, I said I think so, too.
Oh, okay, gotcha.
I just kind of slurred it.
Here, let's take our torch down. We're going to put this over here.
No!
Like, it makes much of a difference, but... All right.
So rejected. 1, 2.
So, that skeleton is probably... I don't know, there is a cave system somewhere. It's probably above us. Okay. This is the next direction we're going to dig. Blech. So I'm going to start that off, but I'm going to do my little window here so I don't get confused. I'll put that right there. All right. I'm not too worried about those. I might actually pick them up on the way back. Oh, as a matter of fact, if I get this redstone, I will get close enough to pick those up, or at least that one. Oh, we got one more down here. All right. Now, I've noticed, and you may have noticed this also, you don't tend to get experience when mining iron. I have no idea why. You get it for coal.
I guess because iron is like, I don't know.
Kind of makes you wonder, doesn't it?
Kind of, yeah.
I thought maybe it was because you're always mining for iron, but you could be doing that with coal, too. fix this area up here. Okay. So we're going to come back here and we're going to go ahead and continue our dig. Now you notice I'm not doing any counting over here. I'm just kind of digging at the moment because you don't really need to count once you've got those torches up. See, there it is. It's our little window light. Boom. Now we can do the counting. One, two, more redstone. Tend to get a lot of redstone. Something else that I've read too is that if you are finding redstone and you're finding the blue lapis lazuli, which just imagine that's blue, you should be on the right level to find diamond. That is our goal. I'm hoping that we can find some diamond while we're down here. Let's see, I lost count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You guys want to place bets and see if we get diamond?
I bet the air you breathe.
Boy. If I lose, that could be bad. I always tend to get diamonds, so...
So let's hope you can breathe.
I don't know if this is a myth or not, but whenever there's lava... I've read that you tend to find gold around it, which that seemed to be the case over there. Sometimes diamond. So you notice how we're doing the torches every 6. It's keeping this all nice and lit. And some people, they prefer to do their own mining rather than going into an existing cave, because this is more safer. When you go into a cave, and you know eventually we'll do that, it's a lot bigger, it's a lot harder to control where the mobs are coming from. Whereas this, you're digging as you go, you're lighting it as you're going. You know, you're not going to have a problem with stuff spawning in here. I haven't. Torch on that side. That skeleton is still out there.
I wonder if there's a cave underneath you really close and it's probably walking around.
Oh, it could be. Yeah, could be. And it could be right above us too.
True that.
I seem to always hit a cave system when I am digging out my mine. Always. There always seems to be some type of cave system down here.
Well, they're, like, really popular.
It seems to happen no matter where I dig, though. That's the thing. That thing sounds like it's close. 1, 2, 3. All right. Got some redstone up here. Side, and we'll do that so we can jump up here, fill that up, and that, just to keep baby zombies from spawning. I don't know if they would or not, but
I don't think they could, but just in case, because this is hardcore.
Always be safe. Treat this like you really were alive.
Yes.
3. All right. Do our little window there. And we just keep going back. Getting a lot of stone. Not too much of anything else. Now, some people argue that, you know, you're wasting your time using a stone pickaxe. You know, you can get through a lot more, a lot quicker by using an iron pickaxe. Oh, you know, I tend to burn through a lot of iron by doing that. And some will say, well, you know, if you're able to do a lot more digging, then you'll wind up getting more iron quicker. But honestly, I like to save my iron so that way I can build rails and stuff.
See, I do that except for with iron and diamond. So, like, I'll use the diamond for the special stuff and the iron for, like, the normal stuff.
Yeah.
Like cobblestone.
Now, when you are able to enchant, that'll be different. Because then you can put stuff on your tools, such as unbreaking to make it last a little longer. You can make it more efficient. So in cases like that, then I will go ahead and use an iron pickaxe or a diamond pickaxe. But I like to get that stuff enchanted first before I start using it as a regular tool. Lots and lots of coal.
I think if I remember correctly, coal spawns in like an 8x8 sort of thing.
Yeah, that does sound familiar. Just gonna fill this up here. By the way, if you have this above you, you're not gonna be able to jump through. Like, I can't. Alright. Hope there's no lava up there. There we go. All right. Let's keep going, shall we? Some more stuff. I believe that's six. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Now that I've got that dug out, let's get this redstone out of here. And if you want to dig out your mine first and then come back and get all your goodies, you can do that. I kind of like to get them as I go. All right. We'll go ahead and fill. So I don't have to fill it up completely, just kind of block it off. All right, continue with the dig. This is exciting. Oh. Okay, here's another thing. Another reason why you don't want to dig straight above you is you might have sand or, in this case, gravel. And if there's nothing below it, it's going to fall down. And if it falls on you, it's going to cause you to suffocate, and it can kill you. It can, and it will kill you. See how that falls down there? Also, be very careful, because there could be a lava or something up there, and the moment you get all these things, you may have an unpleasant surprise waiting for you. There may also be a cave system up there, too. So be wary. Make sure no creepers or anything are going to fall through a hole. Just kind of digging ahead here. All right. Where are we at? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. I'm placing another torch right here. We are running out of torches. Our window.
Wow, that's a really long hallway.
See how these are getting long? But
they're obnoxious.
Remember how, man, if you're making branching, it's really hard to find out, okay, how do I get out of here? But remember, if you follow this mining technique, you'll see this here on the ground like, oh, this is my main hallway, all the way straight back. You don't have any other long hallways to worry about. So you're not going to get confused.
That makes sense.
Aha, we got lapis lazuli up here.
I couldn't even see that. So dark.
Now this stuff you can use for dyeing, making stuff blue.
Dyeing?
Dyeing. Yeah, like color. Color dye.
I'm like, dyeing, yeah.
Yeah, something that you would want to do. But it's more useful for enchanting. Put a torch. Now we can come back around. Now let's repair our pickaxe. And we're filling up quite a bit of stuff. Still no diamond. This may seem kind of boring, but I'm hoping it's giving you kind of an idea of what to expect when you're mining and stuff. Let's make some more torches. So always bring some wood with you. It's always useful. I think that should be enough. I don't want to use all my stuff.
This is going to be a really long hallway.
Yeah. Gravel is good because you can get... I haven't gotten it yet. Flint. Which you can use to make arrows, and you can use it to make flint and steel to light things. I am surprised that we haven't gotten any yet. This white stuff is just diorite, and you can polish those and use it as more building material, which, you know, we'll get to. We can turn our nasty dirt hut into something a little bit nicer. Oh, I think
sunlight.
I just got one. Here it is. Flint, got one. Iron. Now, if you're the type of person that likes to make a branch like every four, like you've got your hallway here and then two on this side, or like two blocks on this side and two blocks on the other side, you would have, I don't know, you would have missed that iron right there. So I find this method of mining to be rather thorough, actually. It may not be the quickest, but hey, you know, make use of the time and the area that you're in.
Who needs to rush anyways?
Yeah. This is getting awfully dark. Thought I saw more iron. Let's see. One, two, three. One, two, three. All right, so you see how it gets dark if you don't put... I think you can put a torch like every 10 blocks and it's light enough, but I like to keep my threes and my sixes.
I just do it until it gets really cold. I mean, dark, not cold. I'm just cold right now.
Whenever it gets dark, it does get cold. Okay. Let's head back here. Let's make some use of our time while we're digging. Go to our furnace. That's not our furnace.
Are you sure?
We don't have much gold. Let's go ahead and just smelt that. In the meantime, let's do something with our redstone. What we're going to do is we're going to save some space by turning... You know what? We have some other redstone. I forgot. There we go. We're going to turn this into a redstone, or probably several redstone blocks. So how we do that? You're going to fill all of this up with your redstone. So if you right-click, you can take half. So just kind of do that. And you make yourself a block of redstone.
Then a just... tip is hold the shift when you hit to get it. Like, hold the shift.
Ah, I see what you're saying. All right, let's hold shift and see what happens. Boom.
And then it brings in, like, as much as you can possibly make.
Ah. You know, I've heard... red people doing that. I was like,
red people?
I read on forums about people that were doing
that. Oh, because you're like, I read about that from red people. I'm like, what? Yeah. Red people, okay.
All right, there we go. So with all that redstone, we've got 23 blocks there. It's kind of like your coal. If you come up with a lot of coal, make some blocks out of it. Makes it easier to...
Because you can break it down, can't you?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you can break it down. Break it down, man. Break it down. All right. So we got some gold. Let's take our iron. Put that in there. I'm looking for that. All right. See? It's daytime. We'll go over here. Finish up our mining. What do you think here? Got two more torches left. Can we get our diamond? Should be nice. I fell down. I've fallen and I can't get up.
I need life alert.
I need life alert. Might come in handy if there's a zombie. Help, I've fallen.
I can't get up.
Torch. Ah, redstone. Okay. Man, getting a lot of redstone. Not much of anything else. Some areas I've gotten a lot of iron and hardly any redstone. Oh, look at that. We've got some iron up there. Oh, let's see. Let's find a way to get up there. Because we are probably... Remember I was telling you about the veins?
Yeah.
There may be more than just this one block, so let's take it down. Boom. Yes, there is. All right, awesome. Let's go ahead and fill this back up. All right. Something spawns up there. Nobody cares because it's not going to come and get us. Okay, we got our window. Two, three. Oh, I'm hearing more lava. Sounds like it's off to the left. All right, we got ourselves some more iron. So that was a very small vein. We had like, what, 3 or 4? Had a little bit more on some of the others. Might be that same lava river, and it probably swinging around in this direction.
Oh, yeah, that could be.
Could be a lava fall.
Oh, boy.
But I bet you that's part of that cave.
Aww.
That's near here. All right, this is where I'll use my iron pickaxe. Look how much faster that is.
Yeah.
This is why some people would rather iron. They rather iron with mining. They rather mine with an iron pickaxe because it's quick. And I'm definitely not arguing that point. It is quicker. I just don't like to do it until I have it enchanted. But if you have a lot of iron, and you're not doing anything else with it, then why not? Did you count how many of this coal that we just got?
Nah, you should have told me before you started.
I didn't think about it. We'll have to do it next time.
I love that noise.
Ding, 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 ding. Or do you mean the bat?
No, not okay. The bat.
Not the bat.
Nobody likes squeaky things.
Now you'll notice on our iron, it's a little dark, on our iron pickaxe, I think I missed, that's all right. There's a health meter on the bottom there. Do you see that? Notice how much more quickly it's going down now?
Your health?
The health of the iron pickaxe.
Oh!
See that there?
I thought you were talking about our health. I'm like, huh?
Nah. Okay, well, we're going to go around one more loop. And, well, I think that'll be it for this side. Actually, go back here. Let's smelt the rest of the iron that we have. See how much more quicker it is to get back here? We know where we're going.
True.
It's really nice. Let's put all of our... I like to organize my stuff. Now the cobblestone, you can sit there and throw that into the furnace and turn it into actual stone, which you can use to make, like, brick walls and stuff like that. Oops. Came back here for a reason. Make some more iron pickaxes here.
You mean stone?
Stone, that's it, yeah. I think about 3 should do it. Should be more than enough. That red thing is granite, by the way. That's another thing that you can polish and use it as building material. All right, let's do this. Oops. Let's do it correctly. Cross your fingers. Hope we get some diamond. This gray stuff is andesites. Again, that's another thing that you can polish and use it for building material. Wow, we must not be in a great area. I usually find diamond by now.
Oh, that's just the light.
Yeah, what'd you think, it was lava?
No, I thought it was the end. Because it's like so long.
Yeah, I know. That's granite down there. More coal. No diamond. Annoying.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I knew it. And then there's another patch there with 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And there's another patch. I'm done counting.
Sometimes when you have a lot of these ores will tend to spawn together. So if you continue to dig out all this ore, sometimes you do come across iron or diamond or something.
I just dig until I don't see it anymore.
Let's jump up here. Exactly.
I have the hiccups.
Okay, let's go our final round. Okay, well.
Well then.
We're going to teach you something new to do. It's called pillar jumping. So what you're going to do is you're going to jump, and then you're going to place a block. All right, so jump, place, jump,
just hold the space place, button.
Jump. Oh.
Your life is easier. You're welcome.
I didn't really think about that, but anyway.
It's easier than just, like, trying to time it right.
Now, even though this is our last one, I tend to always build a window anyway, just in case I do want to continue later. And there just happens to be redstone over there, so let's dig around here.
More redstone.
I know. We're not even ready to make redstone stuff yet.
More!
Okay, no more there. Alright. On our way back. Odds are looking against us on the diamond. More redstone, though. Maybe we can just pretend that's diamond.
Wow, you got a lot of diamond.
Now there's another thing of redstone up there. Getting experience, though. And you will eat through this experience like crazy when you start doing enchanting.
Yeah, because some things are like 16. And then that's pretty much all of it.
Yeah, and actually as you get further up, you have to have at least 30 experience to do some of the... to get some of the enchanting that's even higher.
It gets intense.
And then there's the anvil, and that takes experience. Because you not only are you enchanting books, but then you've got to use the anvil to put your enchanted books on your armor and your weapons. And that takes experience too, so. Yeah. If you're not playing hardcore mode, well, just any mode for that matter, try everything you can to not get killed. Because you won't be able to gain probably even half of that experience back when you go get your stuff. And when you start doing enchanting, oh man, I wish I hadn't lost that experience. But as you can see, mining is a great way to build your experience points up.
And killing.
Mainly monsters.
Well, that's all you can really kill.
Well, no, you get experience from...
Well, not that much, though.
No, not that much. But you do get experience for breeding animals and, you know, turning them into steak. Also, you're getting experience for doing stuff with the furnace. Look at this. More redstone. Just redstone like crazy.
That scared me. My heart jumped.
Boom! A little dark over here.
It's a scary noise.
Light! We're almost at the end. Oh, darn it. Wrong pickaxe. No wonder it was going so quick. Yep. That's it. Nothing.
Where you mad at?
Alright, so well, we do have 1, 2, 3 more sides that we can continue to do our mining at. So let's go ahead and grab our stuff. Let's put some more coal down there. Man, we are just filled and filled with stuff. Let's see. Probably not going to use that. Got our jack-o'-lanterns. We'll use that outside. Let's make some more redstone block. I'm trying to take all my good, valuable stuff here with me and putting it upstairs, so to speak. We'll leave some wood down here. Take that wood with this ticker. Nah, I don't think we need to take our clock. Not yet. All right, let's make some more redstone blocks. You'll find that you will... Oh, let's do shift. Ooh, there we go. Nice.
It puts it automatically in
your... Yeah, I noticed that.
You're welcome.
See that? We're still learning stuff. We're just like one
If you double click, it grabs all of it too.
Does it?
You're welcome.
Oh my goodness. Where'd you learn that?
Myself. Me, just myself, and I.
By accident?
Yeah. Pretty much. I was just like messing around. I'm like, what?
Wow. See, there you go. Look at that. We're teaching you and we're teaching us. How about that? All right, so now what we're going to do is we're going to polish this dyer right here. That's how you do it. You put it in 4 blocks. You come up with polished dyer right. Hit your shift key and click. It's all done.
Ba-bam.
Ba-bam. Do the same with your andesite. Put that there. It don't have a whole lot of granite, so we won't worry about that. And nothing in there. We're not going to need to worry about that. Once you start getting a lot of wood, and well, you'll definitely get a lot of cobblestone. These furnaces and stuff are like a dime a dozen. All right, let's head on up here. It looks dark up there.
So far away.
Beautiful. It's a baby.
No, that's a... That's an adult one.
Alrighty. Are you sure?
We did add, yeah, that's right. We did add some windows. Sun is going
up.
Yeah, looks like it's going up. Like, what's this about? I was like, oh yeah, we built the porch. Yep, it is going up. Hey, there's a skeleton or something burning out there. Ooh, let's go see if we can go get something here real quick. We can get a...
Just don't get us killed.
And there's a whole bunch of stuff up here. Nah, we're not going to get them. They're way over there.
Watch out for creepers.
Yeah, there could be a creeper out here somewhere.
Bless me.
Bless you. Let's survey our area real quick. Ooh. got a zombie over here. Now, see, he should be burning up, but because he's in the water, and from what I've read, zombies, once they start lighting up on fire, they will run for water.
Well, that's pretty smart. Meh.
As long as you hit them once, you'll get the experience. All right. We'll survey our area here real quick. We're getting kind of hungry. Got sheep. Bah. Lots of sheep. Well, this tends to be the edge of the forest here. We got some hills. Did I make those? No, I guess not. If we can get over to the other side over here where those skeletons are at, we might be able to pick up some arrows. By the way, you want to use your space bar or jump key to kind of stay afloat when you're swimming. And you can tame and... Oh, look at this. See. So if you see skeletons burning up, go over there. Pick up the bones. You can use the bones to tame some wolves and turn into bone meal to grow your garden. But these white horses. That's all we got over here is white horses. Taming horses is a kind of like a challenge all on its own.
Yeah, because they're stubborn.
Cows.
Moo.
Moo.
Chicken.
Chicken. We just did.
Left.
Oh, I heard it clicking.
I think. Oh, there's a few others.
Okay, good.
Eggs.
Eggs. Start picking up your eggs. That way we can start.
There's all kinds of animals over here.
Yeah.
Thank goodness.
All right. So I think what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and end our episode here, and next time around, what we're gonna go ahead and do, we're gonna work on upgrading our house a little bit, and we are going to build our farm up a little bit more. Oh, we have a garden over there, but we're gonna make some wooden pens. Ah, more arrows. Some wooden pens, and we're going to bring in. We'll show you how to get the lamb and the horse, or not the horses, the cows and the chickens to follow you. That way, you can have your own supply that you can breed, because there's a whole lot of uses, and we'll get into that. Oh, looks like there's some stuff over there. We'll have to check that out, too. But, hey, let's go check it out while we're saying. We do have other videos. That's pretty much what I was trying to say. So you can click on one of those videos. Oh, rabbits. We got rabbits over here, too. So you can click on one of those videos there. See what else that we've been doing. What we've been up to. We got a pretty nice river system here. So another thing we can do is build a boat. We can build some or make some maps and chart out our area. So yeah, there's a lot of cool stuff that we can do. But yeah, so check out some of our other videos. Click that subscribe button. That way, whenever we have another video that comes out, you'll know. But until then, we thank you for checking out the video. Hope it was useful and helpful. And we will see you next time. We're still alive. There. Door shut.